The Expendables 3 tells the story of Barney and his group of warmen, the Expendables, who are tasked to capture criminal Stonebanks. And I have to say that while the film certainly does have its flaws, it really manages to deliver what it promises and is in fact a whole lot of fun. And at the same time, it manages to be a tidbit self-aware as well. The fact of the matter is, it is fun in the fact that there's an essence of bizarreness about it. It really does now understand what, in fact, The Expendables as a franchise is and really delivers on that note. Although the film does take its time to really get going, and it takes you time to understand and embrace, in fact, the angle that the film is representing itself from, by the end of it, you're really able to enjoy almost this essence of mindlessness and at the same time lightheartedness and to a certain degree even passion that the film seems to have. And ultimately, of course, this is a film that is less so about the characters and more so about the actors, in fact, within the film. And the film really took advantage of that fact. There are scenes in particular, especially one in a bar, where Sylvester Stallone's character addresses to the rest of his men the fact that they are in fact of the past to a certain degree. If they continue on their life path the way they're going, they'll end up forgotten in a hole in the ground. And really, that draws out a very, very interesting parallel of, in fact, the careers of some of these actors, the kind of life and films that they have been a part of, and ultimately where that could take them and what they really want to be and what they, in fact, enjoy doing. And through various recruitments and different team members, you get to witness an interesting parallel between, of course, the situations occurring within the film and at the same time the very contrast between past and present action films with regards to how the present certainly has more focus on a technology-based action situation, whereas the past was far more of a shoot-em-up situation, if you will. And through all that, the film really manages to present the stars at the face of it itself and really push them to be the heroes in these extremely mindless and bizarre situations that you know for a fact only exist within this particular world that's going on. And there are moments, of course, wherein you don't quite get on board with certain things occurring on screen. In fact, when the villains and the heroes really manage to give each other a bit too much of leeway, it gets a bit jarring to witness and feels a bit unnecessary that the film is undertaking certain cliches that don't necessarily work or certainly did not appeal to me. At the same time, the film manages to embrace other ones, thereby making it a bit confusing to witness at first, but really, on the whole, you can enjoy what the film is doing. Because I can certainly agree to the fact that the film succeeds on the level that it promises, but unfortunately, it doesn't promise an awful lot to you despite what you already expect from a film like this. Ultimately, The Expendables 3 is certainly an enjoyable and exciting experience. It understands what it is and never does it try to be all that much more, and at the same time, that does tend to be a bit of a negative. There are also certain moments wherein the visual effects in the film are, dare I say, noticeable, or in fact, not up to the mark that you'd expect a film like this to have, or at least relative to other moments in the film when the visual effects certainly succeed. Furthermore, though, the film is a pleasant and in fact passionate package, and you really do get an essence of a love letter almost from Sylvester Stallone through this film, through what it really means to him to be a part of this and with these actors on screen. And if you're able to read into this film just a little bit more, you might actually derive a little bit more enjoyment, because The Expendables 3 is certainly a fun film, to say the least. It isn't an awful lot more, but I'm gonna give The Expendables 3 a yes.